Hey everyone, this is Rajesh Khade and welcome to my blog rajeshkhade.in. This is part 3 of the series on coupling and comb filtering, and in this part we'll be seeing all the factors together, that is the effect of difference in amplitude of two identical signals and the effect of difference in phase. And to do so, we'll be using the simulated setup that we used in part 1. So if this is the first video that you're watching, I would strongly recommend going back to the first video so that you know the signal flow and also you'll know the basics of what we are talking today. So yeah, do watch the video of part 1 before starting this video. So let's get started with this particular part. Okay, so here we have smart and our entire simulated setup. There's one particular addition I have made in this particular part, and that is that I have added this particular EQ over here. And the purpose I've added this is because I wanted to use the polarity switch so that I can directly change the phase by 180 degrees. And the other reason is that the use of this particular plugin is not introducing any changes. So it's a completely flat plugin. On that note, while I was searching for a plugin to use for this particular polarity switch, I came across a few plugins and I found some really interesting stuff about how they behave and what changes they make. But that is for some other time and we'll see that sometime later. So I'm going to start off with this part where I had left off part 2. So if you remember, I had posted a slide at the very end summarizing all the calculations we did in that part. So this over here is that particular slide which shows us the maximum summation and the maximum cancellation for different differences in amplitude. Okay, like for 0 dB difference in amplitude, we get maximum summation, that is 6 dB, which we very well know by now. And the maximum cancellation is like complete cancellation. Similarly, when there's an amplitude difference of 3 dB, the maximum summation that we get is 4.65 dB and the maximum cancellation that we get is minus 10.69 dB. So let's see all this happening on smart. Okay, so here we have two signals running at 0 dB, that means absolutely no amplitude difference and there's no phase difference too. We know what happens when two identical signals at same amplitude without a phase difference meet. We get a 6 dB gain, and let's see over here. Okay, that's the 6 dB gain. Now let's see what happens when these two signals come 180 degrees apart. And I'm gonna reset this. Okay, so you cannot see anything. Why is that happening? That is happening because they are 180 degrees out of phase and they completely cancel each other. And that's the reason there's no output, because they are canceling each other. Okay, now we'll confirm this by again switching off the polarity and you'll see how the 6 dB comes up. So we get a 6 dB gain when there's absolutely no difference in amplitude. So what I'll be doing now is I will be making boxes to define the maximum summation and the maximum cancellation for every difference in amplitude. Okay, so here we go. This is a 0 dB line when the difference in amplitude is 0 dB. Now let's move on to the next part where the difference in amplitude is minus 3 dB. And you can see the summed level going down. What is this level? What should be this level? According to our calculations, it should be 4.65 dB. Let's see what this is. 4.65 dB. Now again, I'll just invert the polarity. That means I'll basically introduce a 180 degree phase shift. And what should be the cancellation should be 10.69 dB. And here we are, 10.69 dB. So I have made these traces over here for 3 dB and 10.69 dB over here, 4.65, we'll make a box for this again. So here is a 3 dB box. Now we'll do the same with 6 dB. So as per our calculations, when there's an amplitude difference of 6 dB, the summed output should be 3.53 dB. Let's see what we get. Okay, there's a polarity switch. Let's go up, and here we are, 3.53 dB. Now I'll switch the polarity on, and 180 degree, and for minus 6 dB, it's minus 6.04, and we have minus 6.04. So what we are doing is basically verifying our calculations, and at the same time, we are defining what is the maximum summation and what is the maximum cancellation for every difference in amplitude. So I'll do this for the next few parameters also, like for minus 9, minus 12, minus 15, and let's see what we end up with. This is for 9 dB, the maximum summation and cancellation, and the 9 dB box. Now we'll do it for 12 dB with its maximum summation and cancellation, and the box for 12 dB in white color. Now for 15 dB, we'll see what is the maximum summation and cancellation for 15 dB and make a box for that. And now we'll see everything all at once. So here we are. We have defined all the boxes. So this particular line shows the maximum summation at 0 dB amplitude difference. This particular box is for my 3 dB amplitude difference. For 6 dB, 9 dB, 12 dB, and 15 dB. So what this defines is that no matter what the phase difference, the maximum summation and cancellation is going to be defined by the boundaries of this box, and everything else will lie in between. So now when I introduce phase difference, we'll see that the entire comb filtering pattern will lie within these boxes. So let's see that again, and we'll do this in the fast forward motion, okay? No matter what the time difference is between the two signals, and no matter where the frequency peaks and dips are, they are gonna lie within those boxes. We'll introduce the most common or the easiest of the delays to remember, that is 1 millisecond, which gives us the first peak at 1 kilohertz and the first dip at 500 hertz, and then the peaks and dips follow at every 1000 hertz. So we'll start with introducing 1 milliseconds of delay and absolutely no amplitude difference, and we see the comb filter pattern for 0 dB amplitude difference ranging from 6 dB to complete cancellation, and that's our 0 dB line. Now we'll do the same for an amplitude difference of 3 dB and we'll see what happens. Okay, so that lies again within our 3 dB box, and now we'll introduce the 6 dB box and observe the comb filter pattern lying within the box. The same for 9 dB, the same for 12 dB, and for 15 dB. So we see that the comb filter pattern varies between the upper and the lower limits that we have already defined. Now I'll bring up the comb filter pattern traces that I had already saved, and you can see everyone lying within their respective boxes. As the amplitude difference in between the two signals increase, the boxes become smaller and smaller and smaller, and that says that the variation between the peaks and the dips becomes lesser and lesser. So we are at maximum risk of cancellation when there is absolutely no amplitude difference between the two signals. And similarly, when the amplitude difference is between like 4 to 10 dB, there is still considerable amount of difference between the peaks and the dips. However, beyond 10 dB, the difference is almost nil. If you see here, 12 dB, 1.95 dB, it is around 3 dB. So beyond 10 dB, it's kind of negligible. To summarize this, what I want to say is we get maximum gain and maximum cancellation at 0 dB. Then from 0 to 4 dB, there is huge amount of summation and cancellation, but the cancellation is not complete. At the same time, we are not getting a complete 6 dB gain. Beyond 4 dB, from 4 to 10 dB, the cancellation has come really down, but at the same time, we are not getting that much amount of gain. And beyond 10 dB, the cancellation and the gain both are almost negligible. Like, so the last four lines that I've just said, and I've also written it in the blog, are very, very, very important. They are the basis on which we are going to make our decisions. We'll learn more about this particular thing later on in my posts, but for now, with coupling and comb filtering, this is what you need to know. If you have any, absolutely any doubts or questions with respect to this, do comment on my blog, ask your questions, and we'll get it sorted. So here I am concluding coupling and comb filtering. See you again next time.